was your best friend. You guys are trying to find me a wife? Guys, I can find a woman by myself.
Otumba Ayode has asked your father to be his running mate. That is why we have arranged for you to marry his only daughter. But you look so good together.
You have no idea what you've done.
Hold on, hold on, please.
I understand you. You are born again. And you believe in the will of God. So do I. So do we. We believe in the will of God.
Where is she?
What you did to my daughter?
Do you know how serious this issue is?
I didn't disappoint you, man.
Can I help you, young man?
Say you marry me.
Your parents won't even accept me.
I don't care.
I don't know what juju this woman has given me. I really would like to know the name of her native doctor.
I guess you fine.
Hey. Hi, people. Welcome to an exciting time with me. Today, we'll be reviewing the movie 2 Weeks in Lagos. Now, this movie is a 2020 Nigerian movie starring notable actors and actresses like Beverly Naya, Jide Kosoko, Mawuli Gavor, Joke Silva, Okey Uzoechi, Toyin Abraham, Efe Irele, Deyemi Okanlawo, Shaffy Bello, and Tinamba, amongst other actors and actresses. This movie has to do with this guy who came in with his friend from the States. They were looking to invest in businesses. They are born again Christians. Okey Uzoechi came in with his friend. I think his name is Mawuli Gavor, yeah? Okey Uzoechi went to see his parents, and this other guy goes with Okey Uzoechi, and he meets Okey Uzoechi's sister, who turned out to be Beverly Naya, and as soon as he saw her, he fell in love with her. Unknown to him, his parents already have decided to have him marry a big politician's daughter so that they can secure a seat to be the running mate for the next, next presidential aspirant. So his father wanted to be the vice president. In order to, you know, seal this deal, he was like, okay, you know what, my son, you would marry so and so's daughter. Now, this guy, his mom was Joker Silva, and Joker Silva was, you know, calling the whole shots and all of that. Now, as time progressed, Beverly Naya fell in love with her brother's friend. And they eat it up and they started dating, Christian dating. Now, this movie, the story is like so many stories I've seen on Nollywood. Yeah, same story, nothing new, nothing wonderful. As a matter of fact, what kept me glued here were the actors and actresses at play. I wanted to see how good they were, how wonderful they were in, they would be in interpreting their roles, in bringing this story to life. Every movie that has been acted on this story has its own turning point. The turning point is the brilliance of the actors and actresses. Now, back to this movie. As much as the movie was common storyline, it was also, you know, engaging to see. Like I said, I focused on the actors and actresses, and everyone was on cue and on point. No one annoyed me. The role of Toyin Abraham and Tinamba was wonderful, was amazing. Not to talk of Shaffy Bello, not to talk of Beverly Naya and Okey Uzoechi and his friend Mawuli Gavor. Okay, now my problem was that security guard who informed Okey Uzoechi that his sister Beverly Naya had been kidnapped. Where did he come from? How can he be at that place securing that particular batcher when you are supposedly working with other people elsewhere? You see, that's things that don't make sense. And people watching it, you should give your audience benefit of doubt. You should give that your audience, or at least they have something upstairs. You cannot just fling one thing from one place and fling the other thing from one other side and expect it to fly, because those things don't fly. Moving forward, this movie, as much as it was brilliant and all of that, I really don't understand how they resolved everything. But okay, fine and good. All is well that ends well. I'm just finding trouble understanding why a beautiful movie, like I said, I was just focusing on the actors and actresses, and everyone was giving it their all. Everyone acted right the way they were supposed to act. I don't have any problem with the sound, with the lighting. Everything was okay. Just an okay movie. Maybe that I would forget by next week anyway. There shall nothing wonderful. Well, the movie was so-so. It gave the message it was, you know, we wanted. It gave us that thing that we wanted. The movie, the storyline was a normal storyline, a very common storyline that we've seen so many times. We were happy we saw it. It was an okay movie. At least they ask you, have you seen 2 Weeks in Lagos? You'll be like, oh yeah, I have. Okay, how was it? Oh, it's just okay, it was just there. Yeah, the movie was just there. I encourage you to see the movie. Yeah, you can see the movie. Okay, so many things were just not necessary at all. But then, what can we do? It's Nollywood. We can't fling it away. This movie was directed by Kathryn Fasegba. I pray she does better next time. But I'm also not complaining. At least it's a step better than Unroyal anyway. Much, much better than Unroyal. I'll be rating this movie a 5 over 10. Which brings me to the end of this movie review. Up there, you'll see my Nigerian movie reviews, my Korean movie reviews, my Chinese movie reviews, and my movie reviews. Thank you so much for watching. Do join me again next time. Till I see you, it's bye from me.